feel your touch, your warm embrace, and I in heaven.
Good day, Radio Rick Spector from Movie House Productions with Bob Frank. Bob grew up in Crescentville, and he has some great memories of Bond Bread. How are you, Bob?
I'm fine, Rick. I have a few fond memories of Bond Bread. I grew up on Alcott Street, just west of Rising Sun, and Bond Bread was our neighborhood industry. And a lot of neighborhoods in the city had industries that put off smells, but ours, we were fortunate enough to have the smell of baking bread. When we used to ride our bikes back that way, I remember is Bond Bread must have had some of the best truck drivers in the world because those trucks were lined up in close formation, one right after another. By the time I left the neighborhood, Bond Bread was still there, but it did close in the 60s at some point and turned into a Ports of the World, which eventually turned into Boscoff's. I did go back one time to shop, not to get anything particularly, but just out of interest to seeing the inside of the Bond Bread building. As a final note, if you went about 3 miles up Rising Sun Avenue and crossed Cottman and took a left onto Oxford, there was a small competitor of Bond Bread called Freihoffer's, which also put off the aroma of baking bread. So you might say the neighbors in between were sandwiched between the two bread companies.
Elsie and Hal Oetzel lived in Crescentville and worked in Bond Bread's Great North plant on Godfrey Avenue. Elsie Oetzel cashiered and was a secretary for Bond. There were three categories of baked goods, breads, sweet goods, and cakes. Bond was famous for pound cake, and at Christmas time, fruit cake. Pies, donuts, and coffee cake came later. Hal Oetzel was a driver and then foreman for Bond for 22 years. When Oetzel started out, he got the unwanted routes and had to build them up. His first route covered 100 miles and 300 to 400 customers in the farmlands of Northeast Philadelphia. The Godfrey Avenue Bond Bakery's motto was, "We're the plant where no one says I can't." And if you listen hard through the wind, you can almost hear Great North's chant. There is no bread like Bond Bread. All the housewives are agreed that it's good bread and fresh bread on the wrapper. That's guaranteed. If you'll always remember, as you go to door or store, there's no bread like Bond Bread, and we will sell even more and more. Meet Alan Goodkin, born at 41st and Ogden in West Philly. Goodkin ushered and was assistant manager at the Aldine between 1933 to 1942. Goodkin learned the fine art of ushering through a New Deal program in which he was paid $15 a week as a trainee. Goodkin recalled with great pride his role in this elegant era of moviegoing, when men wore jackets and ties and ladies sported fine dress at the Aldine. 15 to 18 ushers were needed to handle the big shows at the theater. Ushers needed to have clean hands, clean nails, and to be clean shaven. They were forbidden to wear their uniforms on the street for fear of getting them dirty and carried gum erasers to remove minor stains. Ushers carried pad and pencil to keep track of lost customer items and change the patrons needed to make phone calls. Ushers could not talk to other ushers except in the line of duty and could be dismissed if they accepted tips. It was poor usher etiquette to point a flashlight above a customer's shoes. Ushers used hand signals to control constantly entering and exiting crowds when movies ran continuously. Alan Goodkin enjoyed many perks at the Aldine Theater, including free medical care from house doctors and complimentary passes to all types of events. Goodkin was hot stuff with the ladies, as he could get them into the Aldine Theater for free.